Good day, learners. I'm Mr. Jerwin A. Gutierrez, or you may just call me Sir Jerwin. I'm from Inusluban Marawi Integrated National High School, Schools Division of Lipa City. Welcome to my General Biology 2 class. I am so excited to be a part of your learning here in Facebook as we discover more about reproduction and development of plants and animals. So, before we start, please share this video using the hashtag EpilibioToSirJerwin. Again, the hashtag is EpilibioToSirJerwin. Thank you and God bless. To begin with, let us watch this short video about the rules for online and modular distance learning. Now, let's have a short review of our previous lesson. Direction: read the questions carefully and choose the letter of the best answer. Just type your answers in the comment section. Question number 1. In which kingdom does algae and protozoans belong? A. Animalia. B. Eubacteria. C. Plantae. And D. Protista. Time is up. Let me see your answers in the comment section. Congratulations to those who answered letter D. And the correct answer for this one is Protista, letter D, because algae and protozoans are not true plants and animals. So they belong to the third kingdom, Kingdom Protista. Is that clear? Next. Question number 2. Cocorbita maxima is the scientific name of blank. A. Eggplant. B. Garlic. C. Onion. And D. Squash. Time is up. Let me see your answers. And the answer for number 2 is letter D, squash. Squash is also known as calabaza in Filipino. It's very nutritious and delicious. It is considered as a vegetable, but technically in botany it is a fruit because it contains seeds. Question number 3. Which of the following best describes the archaea domain? A. Made up of eukaryotic cells. B. Membrane-bounded nucleus. Letter C. Single-celled and live under some of the most extreme environment. And letter D. Unique cell wall component and RNA type. Okay, time is up. Let me see your answers. And the answer for number 3 is letter C. Single-celled and live under some of the most extreme environment. Some of the archaeans can even live in very hot springs. Question number 4. Which of the following is true in writing scientific name of an organism? Number 1, when the names are handwritten, it should be underlined or italicized if typed. 2, the correct scientific name of domesticated cow is Bos taurus. Is it A, 1 and 2,
Is it B1 but not 2? Letter C2 but not 1? And letter D, neither 1 nor 2? Time is up. May I see your answers in the comment section? And the correct answer for number 4 is letter B. 1 but not 2. The first statement is correct. When the names are handwritten, it should be underlined. It can be italicized also if it's typed. The second one is wrong because the genus name should start with letter B, which is capital. And in this case, it's small letter B. The species name is correct. Question number 5. What is the scientific name of garlic? A. Allium sepa, B. Allium sativum, C. Solanum elongena, and D. Solanum tuberosum. Time is up. Let me see your answers. And the correct answer for this one is letter B, Allium sativum. Letter A is an onion. Letter C is an eggplant. And letter D is a potato. Congratulations for accomplishing this review activity. Are you familiar with 4Picks One Word Game? Join me in unlocking these 4 words. Just type the word beside each number and post it in the comment section below. Let's start now. Here's the first one. Time is up. And the correct answer for this one is reproduction. Congratulations to those who got this answer. Here's the second word. Time is up. May I see your answers in the comment section? And the correct answer for number 2 is development. Congratulations to those who got the answer for number 2. And here is the third word. Try this one. Time is up. May I see your answers in the comment section? And the correct answer for number 3 is plant. Congratulations to those who got this word. These are some of our plants at home. And here is the last number. Time is up. Let me see your answers. And the correct answer for number 4 is animal. Congratulations to those who got this word. These are some of the animals that we have, except for the last one. The first 3 are our pets, and the last one are sheep from the old group farms here in Lipa City. Who got perfect in this 4Picks One Word game? Congratulations!
Combining Combining these four words will give us the title of our lesson today, which is Reproduction and Development of Plants and Animals. Just keep watching and enjoy learning.
Again, I'm Mr. Jerwin A. Gutierrez, and you may just call me Sir Jerwin. This is the most essential learning competency. Compare and contrast the following processes in plants and animals: reproduction, development, nutrition, gas exchange, transport, circulation, regulation of body fluids, chemical and nervous control, immune systems, and sensory and motor mechanisms. The MELC for this week, or for week 1, is compare and contrast reproduction and development of plants and animals. And these are the specific lesson objectives of this lesson. The first one is to compare and contrast reproduction and development of plants and animals. The second one is to appreciate the importance of reproduction of plants and animals. And the last one is develop a presentation, for example, PowerPoint presentation, video, and other forms of multimedia to show how a given plant reproduces. Again, what is reproduction? It is the central theme of life, allowing living organism to perpetuate its own species. And what is the importance of reproduction? The first one is procreation, for a continuous existence of organisms. For example, these elephants are continuously surviving because of reproduction. The second one is quality improvement, mixing of genetic materials leading to variation among individuals in a species. For example, these dogs have the same species. But of course, through breeding and reproduction, we have different kinds of dog at present. We have two types of reproduction. The first one is sexual and the second one is asexual. In sexual reproduction, it requires two gametes or reproductive cells. The second one, it involves only one parent to reproduce. And this is a flower. It initiates the sexual reproduction in plants, and it is the most conspicuous and characteristic structure of angiosperm. Angiosperm is also known as the flowering plants. For your information, the world's largest flower is known as Rafflesia arnoldi. It can be found in the rainforests of Indonesia and in the Philippines. It emits an unpleasant odor and attracts insects that pollinate the plant. We have the term here, monoecious. These are plants whose male and female flowers are present in one plant like rice and corn, as shown in the picture. We have also the term dioecious, which means plants whose male and female flowers are found in separate plants like papaya. This one is the picture of male papaya plant, and it consists of the male papaya flower. This one is the female papaya plant. Notice that it has larger fruits than the male papaya plant. And we have also the term hermaphrodite flowers. These are flowers with stamens and ovary present in one flower, like the gumamela. And here we have the video of sexual reproduction in plants. We have also a video here about asexual reproduction in plants.
Hello, happy friends! Welcome to a new happy learning video! Plants, like all living things, need to reproduce to perpetuate their species, to survive through time. Today, we're going to get to know plant asexual reproduction. In asexual plant reproduction, flowers don't intervene. There's no need for a gamete or female, a male cell. In asexual reproduction, there's only one parent. So the new plants will be genetically identical to this. New plants can originate from a single cell, tissue, an organ, or a part of a mother plant. There are two types of asexual reproduction: vegetative reproduction and reproduction without seeds. Let's get to know them. If you want to get to know vegetative reproduction, what root vegetables, bulbs, stolons, and rhizomes are, if you want to learn how plants without seeds reproduce, what mosses and ferns are, if you want to get an excellent grade in your exam, click on this link and subscribe to Happy Learning TV.
This is learning task number one, the Venn diagram. You are going to draw this one, this Venn diagram with plants, both and animals, words inside the Venn diagram. And then you're going to choose from the following choices: A, color display; B, sexual selection; C, extend their species; D, involves sperm and egg cell; letter E, spore formation; and letter F, does not involve gametes. You may also write in the comment section or type in the comment section the letters including the plants, both and animals, if you don't have paper. But you can put the picture of this Venn diagram in the comment section. I will give you 1 minute to do this. Time is up. Let me see your answer. And this is the answer for the Venn diagram. Congratulations to those who got this answer. But of course, answer may vary depending on your explanation. But in this case, for both color display and extend their species, A and C for plants and animals. Because, for example, the peacock are showing their beautiful colors. And on the other hand, the plants are also showing beautiful colors of their petals to attract insects. For the plants alone, it's spore formation in the case of the fern, and it does not involve gametes for the alternation of generation. But of course, there are plants which are involving gametes. For the animals, it's B and D. Sexual selection, they can choose their partners, and letter D involves the sperm and the egg cell. Is this clear? For learning task number two, spot dot reproduction. So you are going to choose the letter of the correct answer here. It's A to G. We have the picture and the description here. You are given 10 seconds to answer this question. Just type your answers in the comment section. Number 1, we are Luzon narrow-mouthed frogs. Calula rigida in amplexus mating position. What could be our mode of reproduction? Okay, time is up. And the correct answer for this one is letter B. It's external fertilization because the male and the female frog are not having internal fertilization. So that's external fertilization. They are releasing eggs outside of their body, or it's in water. That's why you are going to see some bubble-like structure in the pond or in the river. Then this is number 2. I am Luzon sea star, Echinaster luzonicus. I'm breaking into 2. What could be my mode of reproduction? If you will notice, the scientific name is included here so that it can be we can still remember the proper writing of scientific name even it's discussed in the third quarter. So what is the answer for this one? Time is up. May I see your answers in the comment section? And the correct answer for this one is letter C, fragmentation. Because starfishes have the ability to regenerate other parts of their legs for locomotion. Then this is number 3. I am a hydra, having an outgrowth that suddenly separated from me. What could be my mode of reproduction? Okay, time is up. And the correct answer for this one is letter A, budding. Okay, so there's a bud. If you will notice in the picture, there's a bud which will be another organism. Who got this answer correctly? Congratulations. Then next. Number 4. I am a baby Komodo dragon, Varanus komodoensis. My mother was separated from males. What could be my mode of reproduction? Time is up. Let me see your answer. And the correct answer for this one is letter F, parthenogenesis. Okay. Who got it correctly? Congratulations. Then let's proceed to number 5. I am an African nightcrawler, earthworm, Eudrilus eugeniae. I am efficient in composting and was introduced into the Philippines by Dr. Rafael de Guerrero III. I have a male and female reproductive system. What could be my mode of reproduction? Time is up. May I see your answers in the comment section? Congratulations to those who got the letter D as an answer. So it's hermaphroditism because it contains the male and female reproductive system. We are now in number 6. I am a Philippine tertiary, Carlito Sayricta, found in the islands of Bohol, Samar, Leyte, and Mindanao. I am quite shy and nervous around others. That's why I am monogamous, because I choose only one partner. What could be my mode of reproduction? Time is up. May I see your answers? And the correct answer for number 6 is letter G, BB parity. Congratulations to those who got letter G, because BB parity refers to the process of giving live birth. For example, like human beings, like dogs and cats, those are bibiparous animals. Is that clear? Let's proceed to the last but not the least is number 7. I am a Hawksbill sea turtle, Rhythmochelys imbricata. As a critically endangered species, under Philippine law, all sea turtles are considered protected species. Recently, a Philippine village on lockdown delivers nearly 300 hatchlings from eggs of my species, according to Mascarina 2020, to the sea. What could be my mode of reproduction? Okay, time is up. Let me see your answers. And the correct answer for this one is letter E, oviparity. So oviparity refers to giving or laying eggs. In the case of chicken, in the case of birds. So that's letter E. Congratulations to those who got 7 points in this particular activity. Let's proceed with the performance task number 1 for fourth quarter. Each group will be assigned to develop a presentation, for example, PowerPoint, video, and other forms of multimedia to show how a given plant reproduces and develops. Your skills in empowerment technology will be utilized in this particular performance task. I hope we can have an integrative assessment on this one. If you have groups already, you will be grouped into 5. And these are the assigned plants. For group 1, it can be potato, dahlia, or other plant with tuber. Those with tuber. And then group number 2, onion, garlic, or other plant with bulb. For group number 3, ginger, turmeric, or other plant with rhizome. For group number 4, gumamela, rose, or other plant that is propagated through cuttings. And last but not the least, group number 5, squash, watermelon, or other plant that is propagated through seeds. Is that clear? Let's proceed with the assessment. Directions. Read the statements carefully and type the letter of the best answer in the comment section. Are you ready? The most conspicuous and characteristic structure of angiosperm is A. flower, B. fruit, C. leaf, D. seed. Time is up. May I see your answers? And the correct answer for this one is letter A, flower. Okay, congratulations to those who got this letter A answer, flower. For number two, when primitive organisms require only one parent to produce offspring, it is called A, asexual reproduction, B, meiosis, C, mitosis, D, sexual reproduction. Time is up. May I see your answers? Congratulations to those who answered letter A, asexual reproduction, because it involves only one parent. Again, congratulations. And let's proceed with number three. When more complex organisms produce offspring with two parents involved, it is called A, asexual reproduction, B, meiosis, C, mitosis, D, sexual reproduction. Okay, time is up. And the correct answer for number three is letter D. Congratulations to those who answered sexual reproduction, because it involves two parents. Question number four. A fruit develops from blank. A, cotyledon, B, ovary, C, ovule, D, receptacle. Time is up. And the correct answer for number four is letter B. Congratulations to those who answered ovary. So ovules develop into seeds, while ovary develops into fruit. Is that clear? Let's proceed with the last one. Reproduction, which involves gametes or sex cells, is called A, asexual reproduction, B, fission, C, parthenogenesis, this sexual reproduction. Okay, time is up. May I see your answers? And the correct answer for number five is letter D, asexual reproduction, because it involves gametes or sex cells, or the egg and the sperm cell. Who got five? Congratulations to those who got perfect in this assessment. We are now in the reflection part of the learner's packet. So you are going to answer this. Number one, in this lesson, I have learned that reproduction is blank. And number two, I learned that reproduction and development of plants and animals are important because I'm giving you 2 minutes to answer this in the comment section. Timer starts now. Okay, I will read your answers in this reflection in the comment section of the FB Live. And so, dear learners, I hope that you have learned something today. You may still watch this video anytime you want. Once again, I'm Sir Jerwin. See you on our next episode for another exciting lesson in General Biology 2. Thank you and God bless. And these are some of the references that I use in this FB Live. Again, thank you for watching and listening, everyone.